Buying a dream home is always a dream. But when it comes to buying a home, it is very difficult to accumulate so much of money all the time and then buy a house. So we always go for home loan. Especially in major cities like Bangalore, Mumbai, Delhi, Hyderabad, Chennai, Pune, Ahmedabad, Kolkata, the major cities, we always go for home loan while buying a house. So when you avail a home loan, there are certain nitty-gritties to look into. We have discussed various things already, and I'm sure in the coming days I will share more aspects on that. But then, interest rate is one important aspect. When it comes to home loan, interest rate plays a very key role. So within interest rate, there are two aspects to look into. There are two types of interest available. One is fixed interest, other one is floating interest. So what is the difference between fixed interest and floating interest? When it comes to fixed interest, whatever the tenure you go for example, you avail a home loan of 50 lakh and you choose to go with 20-year tenure. That means you'll have to pay EMI, equal monthly installment, for a period of 20 years, which means about 240 months. So throughout this period, irrespective of what happens in the country, what happens in the world, your interest rate will remain same. That is called fixed interest rate. Floating interest is where the interest rate will vary based on various things which happens in our country. So as you know, RBI keeps changing the interest rate, and accordingly, the banks will change their interest rate, and so as and when the new change happens, your floating interest rate also will change. So you have an option to go with fixed interest or floating interest. So which is better, floating or fixed? So now to decide which is better, you will have to consider few things. The fixed interest rate is a commitment from the bank that irrespective of the interest rate goes up or down, they will offer you the same interest rate which they commit you now, which is good to go with in case if the floating interest rate is higher. But the floating interest rate is the best thing. See, look at the interest rate history. We used to pay about 10.2, 10.5% per annum interest rate on home loan 3-4 years back. Today, that has come down to as low as 8.3%, which means you're only seeing home loan interest rate coming down. It is not going up. Since it is coming down, if you go for fixed interest rate now, you'll be fooled because you'll not be able to opt out. You'll have to again switch, pay again, processing fee. Switching is another big process. Why do you want to take up that? Instead, the best option is floating, because as and when the interest rate comes down, your banker or the home loan company will also reduce your home loan interest rate, which will eventually benefit you. So now, when it comes to the fixed interest rate and the floating interest rate, what is the difference? What are the different things? How different it is, or what is the rate difference? The floating interest rate is always lesser than the fixed interest, because bank is also worried. What if tomorrow interest rate goes up? They have to commit you, right? So because of that, they always charge slightly higher premium for fixed interest rate. So good to go with floating interest rate, considering the fact that in India, the interest rates are coming down. Especially the mortgage rates in India are much, much higher than the Western countries, especially in the US and UK, even in Australia, the mortgage rates, especially home loan interest rates, are much cheaper. You will actually get more interest, home loans at 4%, 5%, 6%. So considering that, Indian mortgage rates, the home loan interest rate, should actually go down in the coming future. Keeping all this in mind, it is better to go with floating interest rate. And while going with floating interest rate, there are other options to look into. That is, there is something called floating interest, there is something called MCLR. MCLR is something new banks have started practicing in the recent past, almost in the last 1 year plus. Based on MCLR, in fact, your interest rate again can be less, but the MCLR is something banks keep changing. So these guys keep changing based on their cost of lending, and there's not much difference between MCLR and floating interest. But please revise check which is good, which is cheaper. And also, as you always know, it is better to look at the processing fee as well and the pre-closure charges. Currently, banks have mostly waived off pre-closure charges, but be careful while switching the loan. And also, some of these banks, in case if you have already availed a loan, you are already paying fixed interest of 10%, 10.5%, it is the time to switch your loan. If you wish to switch, please choose floating interest rate, and it is better to go with the bank which is offering you the least interest at this point of time. Also check with the bank, in case if the interest rate goes down in the future, they should automatically reduce your interest rate. It should not happen that you have to again switch from that bank to another bank, because some of the banks are not flexible. Even if the interest rate goes down in the market, they don't reduce your interest rate. That will in turn affect you and will put unnecessary burden on you of switching from this bank to another bank. Because this happened with me personally. I had to switch from one bank to other bank, and when I got the DD from another bank to transfer this loan, that's when this bank said, no, we can only reduce it. That is too late. So we will not be able to wait. So it's better you talk to your banker on these aspects and get it clarified before you opt for the right bank. And when it comes to availing a home loan, certain other things which you need to be careful is, you should make sure that the bank, the documents, see, most of the time what we do, banker is approving my property, he has approved my banking, the documents, so which means the property is legal, property has a clear title, I can apply for it. Please understand, most of the time banker may approve the property or may approve the home loan based on your credit history, not based on the property. Tomorrow, if there is a problem with the property, you are still liable to repay the loan. Hence, please don't go by the legal check done by the banker. It is better you appoint your own advocate, legal consultant, and get it verified by your legal consultant before you choose to buy the property. I think with this, you should be able to make a right decision. And as I said, it is good to go with a floating interest rate, considering it is economical, it is cheap, and you have the flexibility to enjoy the less rate in the future, because the bank, the home loan interest rates are continuously going down in India. Thank you so much.